where a member of Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard has been charged for plotting to kill a former White House official. The U.S. Justice Department says 45-year-old Sharam Pursafi had offered to pay an individual $300,000 to kill John Bolton. Washington believes the plan was in retaliation for the killing of top Iranian Guard commander Qasem Soleimani, who died in a U.S. drone strike in Iraq in 2020. Bolton was a national security advisor for former U.S. President Donald Trump. The charges come as Iran weighs a proposed deal to revive a 2015 agreement that limits Tehran's nuclear program. Bolton had strongly opposed that agreement and supported the Trump administration's pullout from the pact in May 2018. Bolton now saying America re-entering the 2015 deal would be an unparalleled self-inflicted wound.
Former President Donald Trump refuses to answer questions under oath and the probe into his family's business practices. During 4 hours of questioning at the New York Attorney General's office, Trump repeatedly invoked the Fifth Amendment, which allows individuals to remain silent to protect against self-incrimination. In a statement, Trump claimed he had no choice but to plead the Fifth to protect his family and company from what he called a politically motivated witch hunt. The New York Attorney General's investigation is just one of several active probes into the billionaire's business practices and other actions. Earlier this week, the FBI raided the former president's Mar-a-Lago estate in Florida. Media reports said the search was related to the potential mishandling of presidential documents.
No new evidence from Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. as he rests his case in a long-drawn legal battle over his family's alleged ill-gotten wealth. Meanwhile, other Marcos relatives and co-defendants are given time to present their evidence. Adrian Aileen has the full story.
The camp of President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. has rested its Sandigan Bayan case involving alleged ill-gotten wealth, mostly shares of stocks in hotels, amassed by his father, Ferdinand Marcos Sr. In a hearing on Wednesday, Marcos Jr.'s lawyer, Attorney Manuel Plaza, was asked by Sandigan Bayan 2nd Division Chairperson Oscar Herrera if he is considering the case rested. Plaza said yes after manifesting that they will adopt the earlier evidence submitted by other defendants to the case. The civil case involves the recovery of alleged ill-gotten wealth, which the Marcos has supposedly acquired through the improper use of funds or properties owned by the government through their associates or cronies. Defendants or accused individuals include Modesto Enriquez, Trinidad Diaz Enriquez, Rebecco Panlilio, Erlinda Enriquez Panlilio, Leandro Enriquez, and others. Based on the original complaint filed by the Office of the Solicitor General and the Presidential Commission on Good Government in 1987, the Enriquezes and Panlilios illegally acquired shares of stocks in 23 corporations during the Marcos regime. In 2009, the PCGG estimated the subject properties in the case to be worth 581 million pesos. The heirs of Enriquez and Panlilio have so far presented 3 defense witnesses. Other members of the Marcos family who are also named as defendants, former First Lady Imelda Marcos and her daughters Senator Aimee Marcos and Irene Marcos Araneta, have yet to present their evidence. The court is giving them time to present their evidence on September 1 and 2 and October 6. Lawyers from the government side said if they fail to present evidence, they will file a motion for the court to declare that the defendants have waived their right to present their evidence. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.
A warning from the Philippine President's chief legal counsel of alleged attempts to make trouble and cause embarrassment for Marcos. Juan Ponce Enrile, who helped overthrow Marcos Jr.'s father in 1986, claims on Facebook to have credible information on the supposed plots by Philippine and U.S.-based groups. Enrile said he will disclose more details in due time. But he urged Marcos's security officials to sharpen their intel gathering. Enrile's warning comes ahead of Marcos's expected trip to the U.S. next month to speak before the U.N. General Assembly in New York. In another Facebook post, Enrile also cautioned individuals against taking advantage of their seeming closeness to the president. He did not name the persons in question, but Enrile vowed they will answer to him if they continue the practice.